Well, if you're anyone who builds a lot of models, one thing you often need a lot of are small detail parts. And while you can buy those, being able to make them yourself can give you a lot of additional flexibility and potentially save you some time and money as well. Now, for a lot of people, getting into 3D printing can seem kind of daunting. And so recently I came across this little Kokoni EC1 3D printer, and I really liked the way it looked and what it was trying to do. And so I asked for a copy of that printer to review. And so today we're going to take a look at this little tiny 3D printer and see if it's something that might work for you. So first off, why do I like this little 3D printer? Well, I like it because it is small. I can keep it on a shelf above my office desk, have it printing all kinds of small detail parts throughout the day. I can keep an eye on it. If something fails, I can cancel it right away. It's very easy to use. There's no bed leveling to worry about. I can send things there wirelessly. It's just a very quick and easy to use printer, which is why I like it a lot. I do have a larger Ender 3 printer if I need to print something large, but almost everything I print typically is quite small, especially since I do N-scale. So if you do a lot of printing of things that are less than 4x4 inches, this can be a great option. But anyway, let's look at how to set up this printer and how it works. So anyway, this printer does come fully assembled, and so once you get it out of its packaging, it's pretty much ready to use. The power switch is on the back side of the unit, and you can turn the printer on, wait for it to go through its startup sequence, then push the button to pair it with your phone or tablet by Bluetooth. And the beeps this printer makes during startup can be very loud, and they do sound kind of like a smoke detector going off. And that's probably the one thing I like the least about this printer is how loud those beeps can be during startup. So if you think you're going to start this up at 4 o'clock in the morning, you might want to hold off on that because you're going to wake up everybody in the house potentially with those beeps if it is located in a living area. But once it gets through that startup sequence, it's extremely quiet. So that's the main thing to watch out for. And the printer, again, is completely controlled through an app that you can download to your phone or tablet. And you do have to connect the printer to your Wi-Fi network. And you do that by first pairing your device to the printer by Bluetooth. And then once you do that, you can set up the device to connect to your Wi-Fi network. And then you can print to this 3D printer from anywhere in the house, or actually even the world, really. And while there are a lot of objects you can print from the Kokoni app library, you're obviously going to want to probably print your own items. And so you can upload any STL file that you've created yourself or downloaded from places like Thingiverse or other sites to the Kokoni cloud site, where they become immediately available to your application. So then you just select your object, and you have then some simple editing abilities on the app. So you can resize things, move things around, rotate them as needed on any axis. You can duplicate them and print, you know, two or three copies at the same time. And then once you're ready to print, you select the resolution from either low, medium, or high, and then start your print. So anyway, I've printed loads of detail parts for my model train projects, including shipping containers, dumpsters, HVAC units, electrical and utility boxes, rooftop vents, wall vents, ductwork. I even produced this 50-foot N-scale boxcar on the 3D printer using blue filament for the body, black for the undercarriage, and then I screwed on a couple micro trains trucks to produce this completed boxcar. While it does not look nearly as good as what you would buy from a major manufacturer, it did only cost me about $1 to produce in terms of the cost of the filament, and so certainly a very low-cost way to obtain some rolling stock, and you could potentially produce a whole bunch of these on your 3D printer, and then as you acquire more funds, you could replace these with ones of higher quality that you picked up from a major manufacturer. So certainly another potential use case for a 3D printer like this. When it comes time to change the filament on this printer, the process is rather straightforward. The app will actually guide you through the entire thing. And so once you select that you want to change the filament, it will guide you to scan a QR code on the bottom of the filament canister. You scan that, and then it will start a warming cycle in the printer. Once it's warmed up the print head, it will eventually start retracting the filament back into the canister. Once it has completed retracting the filament into the canister, it will tell you that it's time to go on to the next steps. And then you can remove a little locking clip, pull out the tube that the filament goes through into the printer, and turn a locking switch, and then slide up and remove the canister. to put on the new canister, it's the same process, but in reverse. You pop a canister on the back, slide it down, turn the locking knob to lock it in place, insert the tube over the filament and push it in as far as you can, slide in the locking pin, and then it will just gradually insert the filament back into the print head. Once everything is ready to go, it will tell you that you're ready to print and the process is done. So here's a look at the specifications for this 3D printer. I'm not going to go through all of these. In fact, the only thing I really want to talk about is, again, that build plate size. So if you're thinking about this printer, just, you know it has that 4x4 inch or 100mm by 100mm build plate size. So that's the main limitation of this printer. So if it's smaller than that, you know, you're fine. If you do want to print things that are bigger than that size, you know, quite often this probably isn't going to be a good idea for you to buy this printer unless you already have a larger printer. But, you know, for things smaller than that build size, it does work really well. Now let's take a look at the pros and cons of this 3D printer. So the biggest pro, again, I think, is its small size. It's very easy to put this anywhere in the house because of that. You don't need a big footprint. You can really just tuck it on a shelf anywhere and it's going to work really well. There's no assembly required, no bed leveling, and in that, the no bed leveling is really, really important, I think, because if you're just starting out, that can be the hardest thing to do sometimes if you're on a lower end printer that doesn't do that automatically, because I have an Ender 3 printer, getting that thing level sometimes isn't that hard to do, but I have to do it a lot and it's frustrating, so I know that if I'm gonna try to print something, I have to take time to level the bed, otherwise I'm gonna have the print fail. Whereas this printer, there's no need to worry about leveling the bed. So that really does save you a lot of time when you're making a lot of prints, because it's just one less thing you have to do in the process. It is very easy to control this printer. Everything is done through an app on your phone or tablet. So you can send your prints there wirelessly and everything, you know, just works really conveniently. There's no carrying an SD card to it or hooking it up to a computer or anything like that. It's just very, very easy and straightforward to use. It's also very easy to replace the filament cartridges. It is non-toxic filament, so a good option for using inside the house. Now, another cool thing about this printer is that the software has built-in 3D modeling capabilities, and so you can do a scan of yourself, like I did here, and you can see a little figure of myself. You can also scan objects, so perhaps you have an object for your whatever model you're building. Maybe you built it by hand, you know, out of styrene, and now you want to do a 3D print of it, you can scan it and build a 3D model of it, which you can then replicate, you know, via the printer. And so I haven't gotten that to work right yet. The software is still in beta on that. I'll be playing with that more going forward and have a follow-up video if I can get that to work successfully and figure out, you know, what you need to do to get accurate models of the things that you want to make a copy of. Now, the first con is the same as the first pro in that it does have that small size. So while that is a nice feature in terms of how you can store it in a lot of places and, you know, it's convenience and all that kind of stuff, obviously you can't print large things on there. So if you do have a lot of large items to print, you do have to look elsewhere because this printer obviously just can't print big things. Now, while the filament is easy to replace, it is also a negative in that you do have those cartridges. So you are limited in not just the types of filament that you can use, but having those cartridges that have to be attached to the back because they do have some of the mechanism that actually feeds the filament into the printer contained within the cartridge. Now, you can open these cartridges up and replace the filament manually. There are several screws on the back of the cartridge. You can remove those screws, open up the filament canister, and you'll find that there's just basically a spool of filament there going through the feeder mechanism. And so you could technically find another spool of compatible PLA filament and work that through there, and that would probably work fine. You could also, if you really wanted to, just manually wind up some filament on that spool, feed it through the mechanism, and use it that way. I haven't tried to do that yet, and obviously you probably shouldn't start out trying to do that, but just know that a limitation is that you do have to have that cartridge on the back for the printer to work. Now, another downside is it does have very loud beeps during the startup phase. It's actually very quiet when it's running and making prints, but when you first power it on, it has, especially that one long, really loud beep is really annoying, and it's not really a problem if it's out in the garage or somewhere else, but if you're trying to turn this thing on while people are sleeping, you know, that's obviously kind of a problem. So it is something to consider if you do need to have it in a quiet environment. Maybe it's a certain educational setting that needs to be quiet. That can be a consideration, but you can also just disable the speaker you know, and kind of avoid the beeps altogether. It does have flashing lights, so you can see what it's doing based on the light flashes besides just the sounds from the speaker. So I don't think you'll lose a whole lot if you do disable the speaker. But again, just be aware that the noise during startup can be an issue if you do need to have a quiet environment. Now, looking at the prices here, it does retail for $249, but if you use the link in the description, you can pick it up for $219 and save $30 off that retail price. The extra filament cartridges, which are available in a variety of colors, do go for $11.90, at least when I looked when I was recording this video. You can buy a replacement build plate for $9.90, so reasonably priced for that. And you are going to eventually need one if you are constantly scraping off prints off that build plate. Eventually you're going to wear it down, either gouge it out, or you're just going to wear it smoother to where prints won't adhere as well or whatever. So you are going to have to replace those periodically. But if you do cover your build plate with masking tape every time, which can actually help your print adhere better anyway, and also protect your build plate where you have to just pretty much peel it off every time, put a new layer down, you might get your build plate to last indefinitely. So how has the reliability of this printer been for me? Well, it's been really good. The first two prints I canceled partway through because they were just having problems with like layer adhesion. And once I got past that first foot or so of the filament that was coming through, it was fine. So like the third print onward has been all no problems at all. I've changed to the blue and the black filament cartridges that I had, and those worked fine right off the bat. So, you know, kind of random on that first print or two there. But again, for the most part, everything is printed really well. I had a couple issues with, you know, the prints not adhering well to the bed. That's not anything specific to this printer. That happens with all 3D printers. And so I put a layer of masking tape down and everything was fine there. The issue is like when you have a small object that's like tall, where you have a very small surface area holding it to the bed, as it gets taller, it's easier for it to get knocked off the print bed, or, you know, knocked over, because there's just not a lot holding it to the print bed. So either adding texture with that tape or maybe a glue stick, or changing the orientation so it's printing at a 45 degree angle and has some supports holding it down. You know, different things you can do to help with that. So certain objects are going to have problems with all kinds of printers because, you know, you need something to hold onto the bed. If it's very small, it's hard to do that. But otherwise, it's worked really well for me and no major issues. So should you buy this little 3D printer? Well, think about your use cases. If you want to print a large HO scale structure, it's just not going to be big enough for you to do that, so you'll have to get a bigger printer. But for smaller items, you know, detail parts, even on larger scale structures, this can be a great option for you. If you want to print things for tabletop gaming, it can work well for that. As long as you don't want to print really small figures, you'll need a resin printer to do really small figures, but bigger figures or other items for gaming, it can be a good option. Furniture for dollhouses, you know, that could be a great option there as well. If you have kids in the house who are looking to get into 3D printing, you know, because it is so easy to use with the phone app or the app on a tablet, you have the filament printer, it's not resin, so it's safer to use for kids, that kind of thing. This can be a great option for them to get started in 3D printing as well. But anyway, again, if you do want to pick up this printer, I do have links in the description below where you can get $30 off the retail price and get it for $219, at least as of October 2023. So check out those links if you do want to pick one up. But otherwise, that's all for now, and thanks for watching. Bye.